Dear students, what I am going to talk about you today is the Coleman's reagent. Myself, Dr. Digna Varghese. Carbonylation by Coleman's reagent. Carbonyl complexes have many useful synthetic applications. Typical reactions involve nucleophilic attack of the metal anion on a positive center, that is, electrophilic attack on the metal. The synthesis of metal alkyl complexes, one of the synthetic applications of carbonyl complexes. A common approach is to take the advantage of the nucleophilicity of a carbonylate ion. For example, MnCO5- reacts with methyl iodide giving alkyl derivative of the complex and I-. In this reaction, MnCO5-, which is quite nucleophilic and increases its coordination number by 1 by the addition of methyl group. The reaction may be viewed as an electrophilic attack of methyl CH3+ on the metal. Similarly, it is possible to prepare another bridging alkyl complex by this method, that is Fe2CO8-2- reacts with CH2I2 giving a bridged complex. Here methylene bridge is formed between the two metal atoms and 2I-. The same reaction as that of the manganese complex. Other example is acyl halide reacts with carbonylate anion complex forming acyl derivatives. A general and useful method of forming metal-metal bonds that can be applied to cases in which the metals are different. This reaction is forming a metal-metal bond with the similar atoms. Here the manganese metal atom is taken, and when pentacarbonyl manganese bromide reacts with pentacarbonyl manganese ion and forming dodecacarbonyl manganese, and the structure of this carbonyl complex is given here. In this we can see the metal-metal bond is here between two manganese atoms. Another example is forming a metal-metal bonds between two different metal ions, that is when pentacarbonyl manganese bromide reacts with pentacarbonyl rhenium ion forming a carbonyl compound, and in this compound a manganese rhenium bond is formed between this carbonyl complex. So this is an important or general useful method of forming metal-metal bonds if it is a similar metal atom or it is a different metal atoms. One more example is given here. Mercury sulfate reacts with pentacarbonyl manganese giving a compound like a mercury Mn2CO10 compound. Its crystal structure is available in a Springer material. Applications of carbonylate reactions in organic synthesis are numerous. The most important reaction schemes involving tetracarbonyl ferrite 2, referred to as Coleman's reagent. That is our topic. What is a Coleman's reagent? That is tetracarbonyl ferrite 2. The synthesis of Coleman's reagent is when iron pentacarbonyl treated with alkali metal like sodium forming disodium tetracarbonyl ferrite 2 and carbon monoxide. This compound is known as Coleman's reagent. turning our attention now to Coleman's reagent in detail, disodium tetracarbonyl ferrite is the organo-iron compound with the formula Na2FeCO4. Its structure is like this. It is always used as a solvent with tetrahydrofuran or dimethoxyethane, which bind to the sodium cation. This compound, that is Coleman's reagent, usually used as a solvent with tetrahydrofuran or oxalane or dimethoxyethane or glyme or monoglyme or dimethyl glycol or ethylene glycol dimethyl ether. Dimethyl cellulose salt is another name for DMA, but the dioxane solvated sodium salt is known as Coleman's reagent. But only the compound Na2FeCO4 is solvated with dioxane. That derivative is actually known as Coleman's reagent. In recognition of James P. Coleman, an early popularizer of its use, James P. Coleman proposed or discovered this particular reagent, and he popularized of its use as a reagent. And James P. Coleman is an American professor of chemistry. He is an emeritus professor now in Stanford University. So, in honor of his name, this reagent is known as Coleman's reagent. Tetracarbonyl ferrite can be isolated as a sodium salt, Na2FeCO4, 1.5 dioxane, and it is commercially available. And this we can use, Na2FeCO4 can be solvated with tetrahydrofuran or DMA, but Coleman's reagent is commercially available or act as a reagent only with this combination, that is Na2FeCO4 and 1.5 dioxane. Okay, that is known as Coleman's reagent. The iron center of the tetrahedral with the sodium with Na plus OCFe interaction. It is commonly used with the dioxane complex to the sodium cation. The highly nucleophilic FeCO4-2- reacts readily with the alkyl halides to yield alkyl iron carbonylates. We know the carbonylate or Coleman's reagent, tetracarbonyl ferrite 2 ion, is a nucleophile that can react with electrophile and yielding the alkyl product. The alkyl complexes do not undergo beta elimination, and optically active R groups do not undergo racemization. So this alkyl product is stable. This R group or containing alkyl complexes do not undergo any beta elimination, and if this R group is optically active R, but this do not undergo any racemization reactions. Migratory insertion reactions do occur in the presence of triphenylphosphine or carbonyl to give the corresponding acyl complexes. Here, the reaction between alkyl product formed by the reaction of alkyl halide reacts with Coleman's reagent, and this alkyl product reacts with another ligand such as carbon monoxide to give acyl product. Let me explain again this reaction. When alkyl halide reacts with Coleman's reagent, forming a compound like this. This is the alkyl product. Here the R group is attached to the iron center, and the alkyl group is CH. If it is a R plus X minus, so it is a positive charge. So negative charge is reduced here and forming a negative species. And second, this reaction is migratory insertion reactions occur. Migratory insertion reactions means this R group is migratory inserted to this CO and forming a vacancy here. Here the R group is migratory inserted to the CO and here creates a vacancy. To this, the new L ligand is attached. If it is a carbon monoxide, is attached the compound like this and forming an acyl product here. So we are expecting this carbon monoxide is inserted here, but actually not like this. R group is migratory inserted to this CO and creates a vacancy here, and to this carbon monoxide is attached and forming acyl product. The alkyl and acyl products formed have been isolated and characterized. They are considered as intermediates in so many reactions, and these can be used to produce aldehydes, carboxylic acids, ketones, esters or amides, etc. Functions of Coleman's reagent is similar to Grignard reagent in its ability to convert alkyl halides into a wide variety of organic compounds. Here represents the scheme. The acyl product reacts with an acid. It will give aldehyde. If it is reacts with oxygen, it is converted to carboxylic acid. If it is reacts with another alkyl halide, it forms a ketone. If it is reacts with halogens, it forms acyl halide. This acyl halide is again reacts with amine to form amides. Water, it is converted into acid. If it is reacts with alcohol, it is converted into ester. So by a simple Coleman's reagent, we can synthesize a number of organic compounds that is industrially important. So this Coleman's reagent is similar to Grignard reagent that is converted so many compounds to so many useful organic compounds. So Coleman's reagent is very important reagent in organic chemical industry. A rich chemistry has also developed for the chromium trianion CrCO5-2- that is similar to Coleman's reagent. The expected displacement of Cl- occurs when this reagent reacts with an acid chloride. That is, CrCO5-2- reacts with an acid chloride giving acylated complex. This acylated complex may be alkylated directly to give an alkoxycarbene, or the same end may be achieved by the acetylation. First it is acyl compound for acetylated, converted to acetylated product, and followed by hydrolysis, alcoholysis giving alkoxycarbene. This alkoxycarbene or the resulting transition metal carbene have been used to synthesize a wide variety of organic compounds like Coleman's reagent. Thank you for listening.